1876 and 1865 is easy. I knew we'd see him sooner than later. Yep, and then there's the intermodal getting shoved behind him. Holy moly. I knew we'd see these guys sooner or later this morning.
Cold man.
Yeah. Yeah. Yep. These are those bulkhead flats. Yeah, you can hear the couplers compressing under. You hear him compressing as he slows down. I really don't understand how the couplers don't break. Really heavy steel.
Hey man.
Hello. Hello. On hand. Oh, please stand by.
55 minutes here.
Yeah, the slack's definitely in. Oh geez, he's pushing it.
Alright, can we please switch some cars today?
Take it easy there, guys. Oh yeah, he kicked that boxcar off the end. Man, that was a... Yeah, geez, that was violent. I really don't understand how they don't break the couplers.
I wonder if it's just it sounds so big
and prevalent. And I think it's just down to the... Yeah, I think it's just down to the sound because it's so much heavy mass. That's moving.
They're all empty, so they echo.
Yeah, and it's just so much heavy mass.
Now the guy who's standing to your left.
Yeah.
He just threw that switch, so I don't know what's gonna happen.
Yeah.
Could be a little.
Yeah, I see him over there. Yep.
A lot of activity
also. Uh huh. Just revved up again. Slack in. Shove it forward. Yep, I see him. Once he gets closer, then I'll turn the camera onto him. Well, he's backwards.
Oh.
He's going long hood, lean forward. So that's reverse. So that guy, yeah, those guys are going backwards. Because remember, this end, so 1865 is going long hood forward, 1826 long hood back. So these three road diesels are going all main, all long hood back. These three big road. So yeah, there's about 1,300 something horsepower right here. That's about 1,300 horsepower right in front of us. So it's a lot of power. Real busy all of a sudden.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah, it starts quiet and then it gets really busy. It's almost like they suddenly realized, oh, they're here. Let's get working, guys. I think that's another, yeah, that's another remote set. I think that's another remote set of engines. I think this is the other remote set that they use. Yeah, this is the other remote unit that works this yard. You see the lights? up on top of them. Right through the middle. Look at that. That is cool. Totally right through the middle of the yard. We've never had that. Yeah, we've never had that clear of a shot of it before.
I think you two are ruining that kind of shot. You'd like a little more movement, a little more action.
Matt, you a director now?
Hell yeah, bro.
That's hot.
Who's this guy?
And cut. That was good. Everybody go home.
What a director.
You like that?
And then here comes the other set out. Other engine set. Has he got a... Has he got a cut behind him? Nope.
Like Bailey Yard.
Well, Bailey Yard's like 20 times busier, but I can see your connection there. If only we could find a spot like this at Bailey. Great shot of the Amtrak.
Down there all by itself, defenseless.
If only they would just move this line of freight cars.
Maybe they'll come pick it up, which would be much more exciting than just moving it.
Exactly. That might be a head-end set that's getting refueled for later. Or something later, maybe. I have no idea. Maybe. I don't know. There he goes with a cut. Now, if they would just come and grab this other cut of cars and get it out of the way.
In a three track wait. Three track.
Say north end.
North end, please.
Okay.
Thank you.
Thank you. that throttle a little harder, why don't you? Holy moly. Oh my gosh, that was so loud. My ears are now ringing from that. It just does not feel nice. Yeah.
John Sherman?
Yeah,
he used to work here. He's like, a lot of good stuff out there to see.
Yeah. Some of the Carmen.
Break away from this, if you want to go out there.
that 1019's got one of the electronic e-bells on it. Yeah, exactly, that's the e-bell. I could tell by the assembly on the bottom where the bell would normally be sitting. I don't know what type of e-bell, but I just recognize the tone. I don't know what type it is, though. They probably have special order, where they buy like a base station, base communication station, and then buy the other radios as well. A lot of locomotive movement today. Brackets are sitting on the cars.
Those not fifth wheels?
No? Those look like they're for something else. Yeah. And I hear the remote set coming back the other way. Pushing pretty hard. Oh my gosh, she's really got it going. Yeah, it just got busy all of a sudden. Yeah, it just got real busy all of a sudden. It just got really busy all of a sudden. It always does. There's a quiet patch and then it's busier than you can believe. Oh, fuel rackets. All those tracks over there are completely empty. It's weird.
North York.
We're about ready to go. Straight to Sandy Creek. About an hour on me. 20 more, 32.
He's going. That breeze feels nice. That breeze feels nice. Look at the cooler temperatures. Yeah. Thank you.
Eight more long ones.
A lot of stuff moving around. Can't believe that flat car train is still going. That thing is long. Yeah.
One, two, three, four rails of flat, four train cars loaded with rail. Make that five.
Yeah, you see the plastic clips they put on the strap
to prevent the rail from scraping it?
Yeah, and then you see here's more of them, so that's one, two, three, four, five, six cars so far carrying rail. Seven cars. Eight.
Hey, Mark.
Nine. Ten cars so far. Well, it's not dragging in the... It's not actually dragging. Oh, no, it is. Never mind. Yeah, that hose is dragging. You're right. That's not good.
Right, Albert.